Hey YouTube, it's iPhone Mastermind, and today I'm going to be doing an app review on Quickoffice Pro HD, a Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, and Excel editing application for the iPad, and they also have an iPhone/iPod Touch app. The iPhone iPod Touch app is $15, and the iPad app is $20. However, I think they're both worth it because they both have a lot of key features that Word, PowerPoint, and Excel have. And in the future, they will continue to add more features. Both devices are pretty much the exact same other than the layout of the apps, simply because they are different devices with different screen dimensions and such. And today I'm going to be reviewing the iPad app, which is QuickOffice Pro HD, because it is a lot better on the iPad. Because there is a bigger screen, there's easier navigation with the controls and the buttons and whatnot. So this is the main menu of QuickOffice Pro HD, and on the left side we've got accounts such as Dropbox, Google, Box, Evernote, etc. And in the center we've got the display where it shows the files. In the bottom right corner you can go and create a new document, and here I'm going to choose 2007 to 2010 Microsoft Word file. And I'm going to go ahead and just punch in some text to edit later on. And now in the top left corner, you can see we've got bold, italics, and underline icons we can use to format the text with their appropriate elements. So I'm going to go ahead and make the title bold and italics. There you go. And over here, we've got the properties button where we can go ahead and edit the font, paragraph, and color. And for font, we can go ahead and edit the font type. You can see I'm changing around. And the size, as well as elements such as bold, italics, and underline, as you can see the buttons under the scrolling wheels. Now I'm going to go ahead and tap paragraph, and you can drag it horizontally to align it to the left, center, or right. So that's a pretty cool feature, especially if you're confused on how to do that. And down here we've got buttons for indenting the paragraph or the first line, and buttons to enable numbering and bullets. And we also got the color tab where we can change the text's color. As you can see, I'm swatching it around. And the highlight cover for the text if you use that as well. So I'm going to go ahead and close out the properties. And now I'm going to go ahead and format the paragraph a little bit. So let me go ahead and select that. And I'm going to go ahead and indent the first line like a paragraph usually is. And now I'm going to go ahead and type in some nonsense just to make it two lines. And there you can see the second line is not indented like the first one is. And here you can see we've got the indenting again and the numbering button. There's the number function in the app working. There you can see 2, 3, etc., etc. Now I'm going to go ahead and change that from numbers to bullets. Pretty simple layout, not very hard. So here are some other features we're going to talk about real quick. We've got the magnifying glass, which we've got the find and replace in word count. So let's go ahead and find the word test. Then we're going to go ahead and tap the arrow. And it's going to find that one and that one. Then it told me the end of document was reached. So I'm going to go ahead and replace test with trial. And I'm going to go ahead and tap replace all. And there you can see it changed test to trial in the title and the body paragraph. So I'm going to go ahead and be done with that. You can also go ahead and tap the word count button. And it'll display words and characters without spaces and with spaces. So I'm going to go ahead and just tap OK. You can also undo by pressing this button right here, so undo, and I'm going to go ahead and undo again. And if you want, you can go ahead and redo after you undo something. And then you can also print and save as a PDF right from within the document by tapping the printer button. So that's pretty cool. And I'm going to go ahead and save as, and save it in my Dropbox. So something that I didn't mention is that you can do this in portrait and landscape. They both work the same, and the buttons still work the same, having a little drop down from the top. So that's good, and it works in portrait and landscape and PowerPoint, Excel, and Word. So I just saved it in my Dropbox folder. So I'm going to go ahead into Dropbox and open up the document. So there we can see it. We can see the test trial, and it's bolded and italicized, and there's bullets there, and test trial is blue. So that's pretty cool. As you can see, it is working correctly. And now we're going to go on to PowerPoint. So I'm going to go ahead and open up a 2007-2010 PowerPoint file. And I'm going to go ahead and double tap to add a title. And while I'm typing up text, I'm going to go ahead and just mention this one has a few different functions, such as adding shapes, rotating shapes, playing the slideshow. And of course, on the left side, you can see we've got slides and the slide manager. So I'm going to go ahead and just format some of this text, showing you that PowerPoint has the same exact properties basically as Word does with fonts and text and stuff. But with paragraph, we've got the drag to align feature, so we can do top left, top middle, top right, middle, middle, middle right, etc., etc. Then we can go ahead and change the font color, but we can also change the fill color of the shape, kind of like the highlight, just instead it's the shape of whatever the text's in. So let's go ahead and make that cyan. And then properties, the arrangement, I'll show that a little bit later. So now I'm going to go ahead and just format the subtitle just a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and change the color of it, or the fill color, to yellow, and then the font color to a blue. And now we can see the subtitle is over the title, but if we go back into the properties, we can change the arrangement so that the title is over it or the subtitle is over it, either way, which is a crucial feature in PowerPoint, which is what I was just talking about 30 seconds ago, which I skipped. So I'm going to go ahead and move the subtitle back down here. And if we tap the green button and flip it around, we can go ahead and rotate the object. If we go ahead and pull out these circles on the sides, we can go ahead and make it wider. And if I double tap on it, we can delete it. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the second slide and type in some text again. And you can see it looks like the default template for PowerPoint on the computer. I'm going to go ahead and change it from bullets to numbers, back to bullets. Just showing you the features are the same, pretty much the same idea. I'm going to go ahead and shrink it up a little bit so I can add a shape in here. And I'm going to go ahead and tap this butterfly behind a square, or in front of a square, and we can insert our own image by tapping the image tab, or we can insert a preset. So I'm going to go ahead and just add this arrow. I'm going to make it bigger, rotate it, and I'm actually going to make it a little bit less tall. There we go. And I'm going to go ahead and add a text box, basic shapes, text. And I'm going to go ahead and type in more text. Oh, okay, there we go. Move it under the arrow. Make it red. Oh, nope, not that. All right, red. There we go. Make it 100% middle, I guess. Make it just a little bit bigger. Nope, not that big. There we go. Let's underline it and move it under the arrow. Now actually I just made the fill color white by accident, so I'm going to go ahead in and tap none. As you can see, I quickly edited that. I knew exactly what I was doing because the setup is very simple. And then if we tap this down here, we can go ahead and create more slides. Now if we tap the play button, it makes the sides disappear and we've got slideshow. If you tap and hold, you can actually create a pointer. So not only can that help if you're just trying to show somebody on your iPad something, but you can also plug in your HD adapter in case you're doing a slideshow for your family or your job. You can go ahead and use that pointer in slideshows as well. And you can also just go back and forth in the slideshow by going left and right. So now I'm going to go ahead and just save this. And that's PowerPoint. So last but not least, I'm going to go ahead and do Excel. So now I'm going to do 07 to 10 Excel. And I'm going to go ahead and just type in numbers, and let's add a colon. Let's type in 2 and 6. And if you're familiar with Excel, you know you can type in formulas for certain cells. So for E1, I'm going to type in equals B1 plus C1, which will add whatever numerical values are in B1 and C1 and make it E1. So 2 plus 6 equals 8. So that's pretty cool that this app has that feature, and we can go ahead and turn on grid lines right there for the cell we're in. We also got the find and replace feature. We've got the undo and redo buttons. And here we go. We can insert column left, right, rows above, below. Or if we select a column or a row, we can go and completely delete it. We've got print options. And then we've got the same idea with fonts and alignments, color, etc. And then we can also change the borders, which is something different. Oh, and also you can wrap text or merge. I'm going to just change it to default. So you can go and change the fill color and font color. And now we have borders in case you want to change the borders of the cells. So there you go. And by the way, you can add multiple sheets. And I'm going to go ahead and just change the format to number. And change decimal places to 0. Use thousand separator. And you can change the format it shows for negative numbers. So I'm going to go ahead and just make it red. So now to make the number negative, I'm going to do B1 minus C1, which is 2 minus 6, which will equal negative 4. And there you can see it changed from cyan, I think it was, to red because of the negative numbers property I just applied. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. And once again, I will mention all these do work in portrait as well, even though I didn't show them in portrait. And Excel, you can have multiple sheets, although I didn't show that either. So let's go ahead and just show you a quick navigation on the main menu. If you tap these arrows, you can go back and forth through your accounts, Dropbox, or on the device. And you can add more accounts by clicking that, edit them by doing that. Tapping the trash can, you can see it says drag files here to delete, drag files here to email, and drag files here to share. So I'm going to go ahead and tap and hold to the trash can. Do I want to delete? Let's tap cancel. I'm going to skip email so you guys don't see my personal email. And if we tap and hold to share, we can go ahead and choose Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, and more. And if we tap and hold and then tap with another finger, other documents, we can then do a certain option with multiple files, which is also a pretty cool feature they have. And then down here, we can create a new folder. And as you saw earlier, if you tap the other icon, you can create a new document. Wow, I just messed that up. So let me go ahead and fix that. I'm going to tap done this time. There we go. And I'm going to transfer the documents from my Dropbox folder onto my iPad. So quick, easy moving just by changing the accounts. I'm going to go ahead and move it into the test folder. And also, there's a feature at the bottom of the iPad. You can see an IP address. And if I type in the IP address on a computer, I can then access the files on my iPad without having to use a file managing service like Dropbox. So real quick, I'm going to go through the settings. There's not much. You can go ahead and change file transfers, file catch, and you can also set a passcode. So I'm going to go ahead and just make it 1111. And by the way, you can also disable sleep while you're in the app. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of the app and delete it from my multitasking bar. Open it back up. And then it's going to prompt me for my password or passcode. I'm going to type in some gibberish. And now I'm going to type in the correct one, and there you can see it unlocks. So thanks for watching this video. Please don't forget to like it up. And comment below if you have any comments or questions about the app or video. And remember to subscribe for more app reviews, Apple news, jailbreak news, and more. And a quick reminder, QuickOffice Pro HD for the iPad is $20, and QuickOffice Pro for the iPhone and iPod Touch is $15. The names, prices, and links to those will be in the description below. So once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later.